Hey, good afternoon, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus, and I got a big update on what could happen with this potential Gulf hurricane coming up. I still think it's going to be a tropical storm to maybe right on the edge of a high-grade tropical storm, low-grade Cat 1 hurricane, but I am showing it is going to start forming up rather quickly, and we could see a fast landfall. Matter of fact, that's why I like to tell people early as possible what is coming around the corner, because this is going to start bubbling up as we go towards Monday. Now you can see how we have our trough down here, and it's starting to get that front, starting to get these thunderstorms roaring. Now this could form up as quick as Tuesday or as a little bit later as Thursday. Either way, could be a quick landfall as quick as Friday or Saturday. So literally people would only have a couple to a few days to prepare for any kind of landfall. What I'm looking at is somewhere around this direction from eastern Louisiana all the way towards the bend of Florida is where I'm seeing potential this landfall will be. Now, if this storm stays weaker, which is trending, it could be earlier. If it stays weaker and goes further to the west, this is what the Euro is seeing. I've seen it also, it could be a little bit stronger and further to the west. Because remember, this area is where we have that area of lift, a favorable environment. It's a lot stronger in the Pacific, but we still have it coming all the way up into the Gulf of Mexico from the 24th through the 29th. So it is a very small window for this storm to grow, and it's going to grow very fast. Latest information does take it right towards the Yucatan, right towards the northern side of it. And you see everything moved a little bit further into the Gulf. This has gone up to 50% now for the next 7 days, zero for the next 48 hours. But still has the same information that it's had for quite some time now. The northwestern Caribbean, somewhere over here into northwestern Caribbean, or the far southern Gulf of Mexico. One of the two areas, either earlier where it's going to be forming up quick, landfall quick, or later where it's going to be meandering a little bit around and it could actually strengthen a little bit more. So I do believe that if it's going to be the earlier formation, it's probably going to be a strong tropical storm, maybe right on the edge of a low-grade hurricane. I'm born and raised in New Orleans. I'm not no fool to these hurricanes. I know these storms could form up very fast. I do believe any intensification would be right before landfall, as it always usually does. If it goes further to the west, it could be stronger, it could be slower, because the parts moving around is not guiding that storm too much. Now, when you check your chance for a tropical depression, you can see with the Euro, it's a little more on that northwestward turn and not really right towards the eastern side of the Gulf of Mexico. It is taking it where it's going to take longer to form, then maybe come back. So after it goes west, it could turn quickly back towards the east. So when you look at the latest information, you can see here with the Euro that it does build up to all that tropical moisture. And you see this wave right here building up towards Wednesday, a little vorticity spin right there. This is what GFS, also the icon, is grabbing hold of. The Euro is showing that it's going to go further towards the west and be big and broad in the western side of the Gulf of Mexico by the time you go towards Thursday. Still getting pulled by this cutoff low and pulling that to the east northeast. Now, after it gets pulled by this cutoff low, pulls it north a little bit, this trough over here deepens, and then the trough continues to pull it on that eastward pull. So it's showing different information by different models, but you can see the two different areas where this could actually form up. Either way, they're showing still it's going to funnel right into this direction, either later or earlier. They're both pointing right here in this region. So is the icon, but they're both showing different features. Euro shows that deep trough over here is what pulls that towards the east. And at the same time, as that comes northern, this system right here, this cutoff low, would put some shear on that system still and keep that weak as that heads north. And you see how it's still kind of elongated. Shows it's going to take a while for that to build up, gets all the way into the southern Gulf of Mexico. Then it starts strengthening up from Thursday, Friday. Look how elongated it is. Still showing that, and still showing a tropical storm. Showing sometime around Saturday, to Sunday morning. Now, when we go by the ensemble control member of the Euro, which is your more than likely outcome, you can see it shows almost the same thing, but it gets kicking a little bit wider, a little bit broader of a system that don't have a lot of time to get very small around the center and strengthen. So it would be big and broad, and once again showing a tropical storm. And look how it's almost like a peanut. It still has elongated center. And with an elongated center like that, it won't be able to intensify. So when you try and see what the trend is, look at the Canadian. It goes over towards the west, still showing it that high pressure. It's going to be steering it to the west. Then it gets pulled by that system in the south central. But it don't get a good hold of it until it gets pretty close. So it's slow rolling and it's able to build up a little bit. And it's the only one that's showing that westward push all the way towards the edge of Texas and Louisiana, and that would be impacts right on New Orleans again, just like what we just had almost with Francine. Showing that it will start over here, which is very important. This is where the ICON and the GFS sees, but it sees that upper level high is going to be steering it to the west, northwest, and it stays a tropical storm for quite some time. Then after meandering for so slow for so long, it finally intensifies to a Cat 1 hurricane right before landfall, stays as a Cat 1 hurricane. Showing it will be around Saturday evening, a little bit further to the west. Now here's the difference. The GFS and the ICON are trending together, and it's been run after run with the ICON. I did look at it. Look at this with GFS. Not only is it showing that that system is going to be pulling that still to the north, you don't see that trough anywheres coming into play dealing with any pulling of that system. You have the high pressure steering it to the west-northwest. You have that trough coming in with that cutoff low, just pulling that system to the north. And it would be quick formation. It would be starting around Wednesday, maybe Thursday. And then by Friday into Saturday, bam, you got a landfall already. Showing once again, like the Canadians, starting around Tuesday or Wednesday over here. It does see that, but it's not showing that high pressure like Canadians, so it's not going to the west-northwest. It's going straight, and it does strengthen to a tropical storm. As a matter of fact, it gets all the way down to a low-grade Cat 1 hurricane. Now look at the trend. The ICON. ICON predicted Beryl. It was the only model that predicted Beryl correctly, and look how it starts pulling. It's agreeing with the GFS. By Tuesday, it's going to be forming up, and by Wednesday and Thursday, could already be making a landfall. Very fast formation, very fast landfall. That's two things about that. One is good news. It don't have time to intensify. Two is not good news, because for people that's not getting alerted until this system forms, they're getting alerted that literally you have 2 days to prepare for a possible tropical storm or a low-grade hurricane. And that's showing by Thursday, it will be doing a landfall. Forming up by Tuesday, landfall by Thursday. And showing a quick turn and going right towards the coast as a tropical storm. And that is what the AI of the Euro is showing as well. It will be quick landfall as soon as this forms up. Takes it a little bit later where it goes from Tuesday into Wednesday. Then it heads straight north, right towards the same region, showing it be around Friday morning. Very quick landfall, showing as a tropical storm. But look at this. There's something I want you to see here. Whether this forms up and goes straight north, whether this forms up and goes west and gets pulled very fast back to the east or north, look at these dates. So remember, we have from the 24th to the 25th, all the way to the 29th, for the strongest lift in this region, like I showed you this morning. So here we are for Thursday evening, landfall tropical storm. AI, Friday morning, landfall tropical storm. And you can see where it is, pretty close. GFS, Saturday morning, landfall, very low grade Cat 1 hurricane. Canadian, further to the west, Saturday evening, later landfall, Cat 1 hurricane. Then when you have the Euro control member, you have a landfall Saturday evening, tropical storm. Then you have the deterministic of the Euro Sunday morning, and you have it right here in this region. So if you notice, everything is within this region right here for a landfall, anytime from Friday through Sunday morning. With the ICON being the earliest of Thursday. So just keep that in mind. It could be as fast as Thursday. It could take as long as Sunday morning. It all depends if it goes straight north or if it goes west and just meanders around for a minute. So when I go to layers and ensembles, you can see here with the GFS, some of them are showing it's already forming up. Some of them showing it's not even doing anything. And the control member is showing it would just now start to get together as we go through Wednesday. Now, as we go past Wednesday, you can see how it starts forming up Thursday. We're into Friday and Saturday, making landfall right around the Florida panhandle. Now, if you look at a lot of other ones, it could be other places as well. Just remember, this is your control member. This is your more than likely outcome out of all of these possibilities. But look at this, the latest update with the potential velocity anomaly with the GFS. First, we have our first storm sometime from the 26th through the 27th. Showing we're going to have another repeat in the very beginning of October, and this one is showing more strength, everybody. Now, that has been the latest update on what I can see. I'm still thinking it's going to be a strong tropical storm to maybe right before landfall, maybe become that Cat 1 hurricane. Just going to be a more difference in the rain and the winds. I think we need to watch for the flooding event. I think after the system gets on shore, it's going to be pulling all this tropical moisture behind it, no matter what the strength is, and bring a bigger flooding threat even after landfall. I think that's going to be an issue. Now, real quick, I wanted to answer a couple of questions. I know you got to have thick skin here on YouTube because people is all over the place with what they say, and a lot of them don't get a personal relationship, so you really don't care what they tell you because there's no emotion attached to it. My problem is I care, and I care about everybody, so that's a big issue with me. So for those that think, hey, it's kind of naive to think that you're saying, oh, this can't be no hurricane, maybe a low-grade hurricane. I'm born and raised in New Orleans. I've been through two hurricanes myself. I know the damage it does bring, and I do not throw that around carelessly. I'm trying to give you the truth of what I feel, and I don't want to throw out some fear-mongering major hurricane. I'm seeing that off the table because the downgrade that I've seen in the MJO, the lift that's moving over from the Pacific, is going to be a lot stronger in the Pacific. And what we do have that peace in the Gulf. So I'm just giving you my honest opinion. The only reason I'm even talking to you about it is because actually I do care. And then other people are saying, hey, why are you even posting this? Because it hasn't even formed yet. And the reason why I am is because things are showing me that as soon as this forms, people are going to have literally a few days to prepare and still don't know which direction it's going. There's so much dancing in the atmosphere. When this forms, it could give you a few days to get ready or a few days for a landfall. And a lot of people, as you know, in this economy right now, it's very hard right now to even save up money, nevertheless buy materials that you might have to wait for the next pay period. So that's why I like to go early. Matter of fact, I am the only person that I know of that told you about all this favorable environment coming over a month ago, trying to prepare you for this moment. So I'm here for them, my best intentions, trying to help you the best way I can. I'm not never going to do fear-mongering porn. I think that's the worst way to go. If people want you, they should have you for the truth and the honesty coming out, not for what's trending, not for what people want to hear. I will never be a sellout in that direction. Now, all this moisture is going to start building up, all this convection, all that blue is thunderstorms, as thunderstorms growing up, a lot of lift. This is going to keep going all weekend long, and maybe as we get towards Monday, we can start looking a little more seriously on what's going to potentially happen with this wave. Until then, it's going to be a little bit of hit and miss from what I can tell. One seeing a trough, one seeing a cutoff low. So these weather models are all over the place on what could potentially happen. So I will give you my latest information Sunday morning after Sabbath. And I also tell you this just to beat the comments. Oh, you don't care. You just do. I do care. My problem, whether it is a problem or not, my big issue is that I do care. And if you look out there, you'll see a lot that do not care. Now, before I go, Luke 6, 30 through 36. This is Jesus speaking. Give to every man that asketh of thee, and of him that taketh away thy goods, ask them not again. And as ye would that men should do to you, do ye also to them likewise. For if ye love them which love you, what think have ye? For sinners also love those that love them. And if ye do good to them which do good to you, what thank have ye? For sinners also do even the same. And if ye lend to them of whom ye hope to receive, what thank have ye? For sinners also lend to sinners to receive as much again. But love ye your enemies, and do good, and lend, hoping for nothing again, and your reward shall be great, and ye shall be the children of the Highest, for he is kind unto the unthankful and to the evil. Be ye therefore merciful, as your Father also is merciful. Amen. Have a great evening, everybody. I will see you first thing for Sunday morning, and I will have my uploads every afternoon as well. I do believe we're going to be looking towards a faster landfall than expected for next week. I will see you first thing on Sunday morning, and remember, all glory does go to God our Father, Yahweh, in heaven. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and everyone that is around you. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Happy Friday, everybody.